rotavirus, I'm concerned about the rotavirus today. That's why I'm here today, just to return from the seed of Abraham. I feel that what we need to do, we are praying for the Thomas family, those that have lost loved ones down in Dallas. But I feel that we have to have more resources as I look at the rotavirus that's sweeping South Africa, that we need to close our borders. The planes come in, people need to be tested. People that come in on cargo ships, those that are bringing products in this country, those that's on trains, those that come in here to Chicago, New York, California, those that come in this country from England, France, London, we need to check them to see if they safe. One of the things that we as citizens need to do, be alerted about this virus that's going on throughout the world. And I feel, and I feel that Brother Thomas didn't get a fair shake. He was sent home by the hospitals in Texas. They didn't really look at his case. I don't know, maybe because he was black, maybe because the people that the hospital got on staff is not sensitive. So those people need to be replaced and put somewhere else. Because he came in the emergency room for help. And I feel that the doctors on board should have used the same medicine they used for the two doctors that came from South Africa. And now, we don't know if this thing spread it or not, but we have to be alarmed about it. And I want to thank President Obama for sending soldiers and troops over there to set up new facilities. We got to grapple with this problem of global warming and of the Ebola virus. We have to deal with that. As I come to you today to tell you that we have to work some out to do something about this virus. The only way we can do is begin to work it out and see what we can do to work this virus out. This is Bishop kind of taking a look at the virus, what it could do to Chicago and New York, what it could do to our industry if we don't get a hold on it. Now, when they brought the two doctors back, in a month's time, they was cured. And when Brother Thomas came, and he got there late, and he got on the 28th, he got there on the 25th, hospital turned him down. 2 days later, the family had to call to Washington, and they called him back in the hospital. And after he got in the hospital, they didn't use the same drugs that they used for the doctors. And even the blood from the doctors did him good, the antibodies. So I'm saying that I think racism played a part in their slow response. And we can't tolerate that in America. We can't tolerate what went on at that hospital sending people home when they're sick. We can't tolerate that. But it's been the norm in Chicago, New York, California. It's been the norm. They do that. You come over there for a headache, they send you back. One lady was sick, sent her back, she died at home. So the hospital got to tighten its belt up to make sure that happened. As I look at this virus, and I'm praying that it go away, we, the scientists and the doctors of the world, must come together. We need a world meeting of all the doctors and the pharmaceutical companies to come up with a solution to deal with the Ebola virus. And 1,000 people a week in Africa is dying. And they're saying it's more than that. That's just a rough estimate of the people that are leaving here from this virus. So we need to get a hold on as a people, as the world people. I'm talking about the world. I look at the world, and because of the internet and because of our internet, we're global, we're tied together. We're praying for the typhoon. People had problems with the typhoon and people in China. So we're interconnected, so we must fight this disease globally. And we must stop it in its tracks. I feel that we can do that as a people. So as I look at this virus as I look at the disobedience of people to God. So I'm praying that God will intervene. If we pray, God will intervene. And I'm going to pray now. Father God, we ask you right now to dispatch your angels to deal with this evil virus. And I call the angel Raphael, the healing angel. And I call the spirit of our ancestors to go forth and give us revelation knowledge of how to stop this virus from attacking our people globally. And I know it can be done. I'm looking at the virus, and I'm taking a look at it so we understand that we have to work with our Native American brothers, our brothers in South Africa, our brothers here in Chicago, Mississippi, Louisiana, Alabama. We're praying that we can lubricate this violence it'll go away. So we're asking you to come in, and I'm asking every missionary that's there coming back, let's set up a prayer wall. I'm going to pray every day at Friday. I'm going to start the praying every evening. Join in with me for a 15-minute prayer where we can stop the killing of all these people with this virus. And I know it can be stopped. And I know it can be stopped. So we'll pray. As I look at it, I see that we have to take measures to make sure this virus don't hit your family. And in Dallas, Texas, if they had did the right thing at the right time for the right reason, and I believe Brother Tones would have died. That's my belief. I just believe that there was lack in treating him. They didn't quarantine him. They didn't go in to try to save him. They just experiment drugs. But the same experiment drug they used on the three doctors, they should have used on him. And they should have got some blood from one of the doctors and put it in his outer body and see what it would do. But all that said and done, this is Bishop Turner from the seed of Abraham. Go to my website tonight. I will be talking about that virus along with Mr. White. We'll be talking about that virus and what we can do with that virus. That's what we'll be doing with that virus, talking about it and see what we can do with it.